Hello YouTube, welcome back to my video. In this tutorial series, we are going to talk about what is Hibernate, why we need Hibernate, and other important concepts of Hibernate. This is a crash course actually. I'll be covering up all the important concepts quickly and with real-time examples. Here we go. By definition, Hibernate is an ORM tool which is used to map plain Java object to relational databases, thereby object relational mapping. And also it support all the relational database like MySQL and Oracle. A little modification is needed if you want to change complete database. Hibernate would have a config file which contain all the info about the database. You just need to update that to change the database, so the other overhead of database and supported queries will be reduced. It also support the auto DDL, which means data definition language. It would create, alter, rename the tables and all other kinds of stuff in the database. So we have discussed all these points: object relational mapping, support all relational database, a little modification is needed if you want change complete database, and it also support the auto DDL. Suppose if you are having a student class having variables like ID, name, and if you want to persist or save this in the student table which is having the columns ID and name, you should have the query like this. The query, and you have to take care of the prepare statement and get the values appended and then execute the query. Same way, if you are taking values from the table, like you should have the select query and again statement, result set, arrays. So in fact you have to take care of open connection and create statement and result set, list and arrays. You'll have to take care of all these and then execute query, and most importantly you should mind closing connection, closing the statement, all other thing. And suppose if you are using the handwritten code, so it will be so difficult to change the column name, and it will be the database dependent. The most of the handwritten code will be database dependent, and you should take care of that also. So suppose if Hibernate says like Hibernate will take care of all this, you don't want to do anything, so isn't it great? So Hibernate will take care of all these pointed statements and make it easy for you. Well, let's check the Hibernate versions of these two operations, like the insert query and the select query. The insert query will sum up to two lines here. You just need to create object of the student class and hand over it to the session object, and it will save the object for you. Similarly, for the select query, it can be written in a single line. The process of the result set, collection list and all other headaches will be removed by this. All these are done with the help of HQL, which means the Hibernate Query Language, which reduce the handwritten code by 80% and given a better code readability characteristic to the Hibernate. So HQL is completely database dependent and thereby strengthening the Hibernate worth of use. So we have discussed this point, like take care of opening and closing database automatically and better code readability, and all the HQL is Hibernate, the database independent query, so you don't want to worry about if you are changing the database from one system to another. Maybe you are using Oracle, you can use it MySQL or any other database without any problem. Again, there is another feature from Hibernate known as caching mechanism for faster retrieval of data. When a user is requesting something to the server, Hibernate first check to the cache memory whether the requested data is available in the cache memory or not. If it is not available in the cache memory, it will retrieve the data from the server. This actually reduces the hitting of the request to the server each time the user requests, thereby enhancing the speed of the application. So this feature is a very important feature. Hibernate provides second level of caching for each request what user makes. Now we have discussed two more points, like a good cache mechanism for faster retrieval of data. This is done as I told, this is an important feature from Hibernate. And again, now it Hibernate provides a validation support in the form of annotation. We'll check this in our next tutorial. What is this validation support? Please note this down. This is also a very important point from Hibernate. This validation support is actually a Java standard support. So the Hibernate recommends to use this annotated format for the validation. Now we have to check three more points again. So Hibernate is built on the top of JDBC, which means that Hibernate can do whatever the normal JDBC what does to Java. So don't worry on implementing new systems in your old software or old application. It's on the top of JDBC, which means there is like there is it cannot be, there is nothing like it cannot do something which is doing by JDBC. And again, so Hibernate have good exception handling mechanism. It have only a runtime exception, no compile time exception will be the like a class not found exception. Again, the Hibernate also provides just like ORM, it support OGM for all non-relational database like MongoDB database and H2 database. OGM stands for Object Graph Mapping. So that's all for now about Hibernate. We'll check further in the next tutorial. And if you like this video, please like and subscribe for my videos. And let's see in next tutorial. Thanks for watching.